Hey guys, it's Gary with Upton Bass. Just a quick how-to video, something that seems so obvious that isn't. We're gonna put a bass in a bag. The number one thing that I see guys doing is they have their bag full of extra strings, their bow case with a bow, maybe two bows. They've got music in the back, a reel book, who knows what. They approach the bass just like this. Take the bag, and I have nothing in this bag, by the way. They take the bag, they throw it on the scroll, and this is the beginning process of bagging up the bass. Look what you're doing. You're putting, the bag alone weighs 10, 15 pounds. I've seen bass bags that have 30, 40 pounds worth of crap in them. CDs, everything, iPhones, iPads, people are using those for music now. All of that weight torsionally on the scroll. If I went over to the scroll and hung a weight off of here, you guys would be like, no, stop. If I was twisting as hard as I could, you'd say, no, stop. It's exactly what you're doing when you're putting a bass bag and you're hanging it over the scroll. So, simple. Try to not throw the bass on with such a deep angle. Stay central and hold the bag with your hands while you're positioning it like so. Once you've got it around the body, now you've got the weight on the rest of the instrument. As you start to zip it up, you're really starting to help, bear the burden of your case on the bass. Lay it down, zip it up, and if your bag has one, the next cinch that everyone says, what the heck's the point of that? Make up that little bit of slack. A lot of these bags are one size for all, 3/4, 7/8 size bases. So when you make up this little extra bit of slack, again, you're not just sitting all that tension on the scroll. So that's the biggest thing I see. Why do we see scrolls snapping off of bases? Granted, the bass does have 200 pounds plus of string tension pulling on the scroll at all times. We don't need to help it in the process of snapping the scroll off. Another simple thing, standing with your bass, picking the instrument up. I personally, if I have an amplifier, I want my amp in my right hand and the bass in the left hand. If I don't have an amp, I like that I can hold away a person in the street, a closing door, so on and so forth. Just be cautious, again, getting the right fitted bag for your bass. I would rather see a little bit of slop around the bridge. The body doesn't bother me if it's nice and tight, but a little bit of slop around the bridge than having a bass bag that's cramming on the bridge all the time. I hope that helps. There's more to come. But those are some really critical things to keep your instrument safe inside your bass bag. Thanks, guys.